Hello, my dear friends, how are you today? This is going to be my review on the Presonus sphere. This is a subscription based from Presonus that in fact will give you the full studio one, I think version 5, the latest version, with almost, I think, not almost, all of Presonus plugins. So you are getting a full-featured DAW. You are getting all of Presonus plugins. And you are getting all of Presonus instruments. And you're getting notation, some program for writing notes. I'm not using it. So I registered to this subscription because, in fact, I'm still using a cakewalk of BandLab. And I love this program a lot, but... one of the main reasons I got this subscription to Studio 5 because you can buy courses to Studio 5 at Udemy or things like places like this, but you almost cannot find an order course, online course to cakewalk. And the features you've got here with this subscription, a cloud, let's say, it's immense. It's a lot of things you are getting for, I think, $15 or maybe $25 per month. You are getting a bundle of software that costs many thousands of dollars. So if you are limited on budget and you want something professional to start with all the things you need for as a producer, in fact, this is the most thorough and cheapest way to start. And even as a professional, you can use this and... you know, Studio One is one of the best DAWs today, 2021. So you've got so many courses and special things to this subscription. I won't get to the subscription itself and all the features you've got within because I want to go over Studio One and all the sounds you are getting and the features. Let's go over them. Of course, I will focus on the piano, but let's see what you are getting here. Okay, so this is the Studio One. DAW. I will take the mix down. So as you can see, this is the side of the browser. Here you can see all of your VSTs. So I installed the full version with all the add-ons that I can get at the subscription of Studio One. So it's pretty filled my hard disk. So yes. It's about 200 giga of installment, and you've got here the effects, the full loops. There are many loops here. And let's go over the instrument you are getting. So this is the track I'm using to speak with the microphone, let's say. Let's change the name. And now let's get into the instrument. There is multi instruments here, so it's combination of several instruments together. And this is a very interesting section, but let's go. So at the Presonus, when you are installing everything, you have got four main engine that Presonus give you. It's the impact, it's the engine of drums. The Maita, it's sort of, the Maita and the Mojo are sort of synthesizers sounds. The presence is the main engine I'm using. It's with all the orchestral sound and the sampled, let's say, sounds. And there is a sample one, it's a sampler engine. I don't know how to use it, so I'm not using it. But let's go to the presence, because this is the main focus. So if you are getting the lightest, I bought Atom SQ. It's a controller for the Studio One, and you are getting with this controller the artist bundle for free, the Studio One for artist. Although with the subscription to Sphere, I'm getting the full professional version. But here is the artist instruments. So this is the light, let's say, light version. And let's hear some of them. This is the 303 bass. So you see the size of megabytes for each of these instruments. This is 85 kilobytes. Okay, this is very small samples. This is 4 megabytes. Okay, you are getting the... the sound, some of them are usable and some less. Okay, so you can hear the level. It's not very high level. You see the guitar, it's 2.6 megabyte of sample. It's very small, but it's usable for beginner. But here you are getting all the professional stuff you are getting. So let's go over them. So let's go to the bass. So we got 6-string bass, contemporary bass, fretless bass, upright bass, vintage bass, and of course instruments and effects. Okay, so this is very feral library of sounds, of instruments. Let's go to the clean ones. 6-string bass full. The open version. Here you are seeing 70 megabytes, not 7 megabytes. Okay, this is more. Okay, something happened. Okay, of course you have the triggers. On each sound you can see here the red. This is triggers. that will change some articulation of the sound. Let's see. This is muted it. And let's see what this will do. Okay, so this was the six string bass, contemporary bass, fingered, picked. Let's see what it is. So we can see you have all the options of each bass, okay? Fretless bass, this is one of my favorites. Okay, and upright bass. With the hammers on. So you can see how thorough this is. And just as much the brasses, let's hear the brass, let's hear the trumpet. So you see, this is 155 megabytes of sample. So this is a logical. Let's see the articulation. So you can see how multi-dimension this is. So, you know, libraries of orchestras at this level costing lot of money, let's say, okay? So this is a bargain, you know, the DAW, you've got here Melodyne pitch correction, professional pitch correction, for free with this subscription. All these sounds, listen to the sounds, listen to the trombone, listen. Again, with each one of these sounds, you've got all the articulation, the French horn. Let's hear the French horn full. the right sound for it, but let's see the flugelhorn. Okay. So you can hear the quality and the size of the samples here are marvelous. Deep Flight 1. This is because I installed all of my options here. So it's installed so many instruments. This is the digital choirs. So many sounds, so many engines for so little money. And you can hear the quality. Okay, let's see the keys, analog keys. Listen, I have to see if the volume here, sorry, I want to check something at this. Something at the sound here. so it won't get too loud. Never mind, I can't find it. I hope the audio sound, it's not too loud. You know what, I will do it on the Studio One. So let's go here to the mix section, and let's add here a limiter just for being sure. Let's put it on minus 1 dB. So it won't crank your ears. Okay. So now it's also on my ear headphones, and also at your, let's go back to our presence. Okay, the levels here. Okay, so let's go on. So you can hear here, let's see what these digital keys are. Okay, let's see what is the leads, dance leads. Noisy. And this is one library, yes? This is crazy libraries. Pads, analog pads. See how many pads. And this is only Deep Flight 1. Digital pads. Gated pads, noisy pads. Soundscapes, and this was only the Deep Flight One, e-piano and organs, EP big chord. first time with all of these sounds. Listen, what a nice road sounds. Is very loud, but you can see suitcase. So endless amount of, and this is e-pianos and organs. This is new section when I installed the regular package, not the full package. There wasn't. So this is new. Listen to the guitar you have here. I don't get into the instrument plus effects because this is a world of itself, but let's listen to the clean. The clean Les Paul. Legato. So endless possibilities. Let's listen to the nylon guitar. Listen to this. So the subscription to Waves, let's say, or Splice, all of these subscription based VST, let's say, you are getting all the effects, all the instruments, all the DAW. Here you are getting all of them together. So you can see the quality of the instruments. Steel string guitar. See how many steel string guitar you are getting here. Big steel string. This is 430 megabytes of sample. Listen, people. You know what? Listen, what a beautiful guitar. Stratocaster. Straight caster. Telecaster. Let's go to the keyboards. C, the accordion 8. So a beautiful accordion, as you can see. So many different accordions. Clavinets. Of course, you've got here a clavinet with wah-wah effect. I'm using the mod wheel to trigger the wah-wah here. So as you can hear, many, many instruments. Let's see the Rhodes, MK1, and of course, almost on each of them, you've got the instrument, with effects. Let's see, this is the full vintage. Dynamite boost. Little bit the overdrive. Anyway, the Rhodes suitcase, the Wurlitzer, you've got here everything you want, top-notch sounds, except, I cannot say except, but as you can see here, you've got full organ section. Okay, drawbar organ, so you can mess with each of the parameters, the eighth. In fact, it's ninth parameter, so let's leave it like this. Organ full, Jimi Hendrix organ. Okay, as I told you before, so many instruments. Let's go to the piano. So there is the regular piano and there is the studio grand sample. So let's go to the studio grand sample. Let's open the condenser mics. And I will fix some things here so it will sound a little bit nicer. Okay. So first of all, you are taking down the velocity curve, and because this piano is a little bit on the bright side, whoa, there is a panning running on. So sometimes it keeps some of the effects from the previous patch. So let me, and I don't know how to get rid of it. So for now I will take it off and on again. Let's go to the piano and to the condenser, and let's hear if it's gone. Yes, it is gone. So let's take the velocity curve and the envelope release. So this is pretty big. In fact, it's the biggest piano VST I've got. So you can see almost each of the sample sets. It's 750 megabytes. So let's say the noir, it's about 250 megabytes per sample set. When you are loading a sample set, yes? And the UVI even smaller. And also the VI labs, it's about 200, 300 megabytes per sample set. Piano sound, it's nice, but it's too bright for me. Let's compare it to my Kawai piano, let's say the SK. So let's bring it down, let's add a stereo, and let's see it on the right input. So as you can hear, and now let's hear the Presonus piano. Let's boost the volume a little bit. Kawaii. So you can hear the quality difference. There is a big difference, I think. So what do you think? Anyway, there is an option, because now I loaded the condenser mic and there is a ribbon mics here. So the ribbon mic sounds even more bright than the condenser. But together, something interesting happening, because, and there is a patch. Let's hear the, this is the ribbon. Although now the ribbon sounds much more mellow. Now, as you remember, this is 713 megabytes. But let me show you something interesting I just find out recently. So there is a patches here that are a combination of many instruments together. So there is a multi-mic piano. In fact, it two instances of this grand studio grand piano of Presonus. One is the condenser mics, and the other one is the ribbon mics. But listen, there is something special. Let's take down the velocity curve and I don't know what is this realism, but let's listen to the sound now. It sounds much better. And I found out something very special. If I will pan the ribbon to one side and the condenser to the other side, then there is this special effect. But if I, let's remove it, let's take the original before I tweaked it and let's hear it and hear the difference, hear the difference. Hear the difference. It's nice, but listen, this is the original, let's say, and this is with my tweaks. But maybe it's loaded both of them, so let me remove and put together, put the instruments together, because it's loading the same samples twice. It's like a 1.5 gigs of sample set. Okay, so it's pretty heavy. I don't know what this realism doing. You can enter here and see the way they This is the realism. Knob 7, but what? It's a sign for what? But still, even though the kawaii sounds better, and it's of course it's the volume. Yes, I need to take down a little bit the kawaii volume. And let's listen to the UVI Model D, only 50 megabyte sample, okay? Only 50 megabyte sample versus 1.5 gigabytes, you see, 49.09 megabytes. This is the Key Suite Model D. Of course, sample of the Steinway D, the concert grand of Steinway & Sons. Let's change the velocity curve here too and fix this too, so you can hear it's bright. It's a nice piano, I'm not saying it's not, but it's a little bit disappointing, the size of the samples and the quality of the piano. Like, so you can hear what's going on. So except the piano, the other sounds here are just marvelous. And let's get to the effect, because you've got here all the effects you want from, and all of these effects are very expensive effects. The effects chain, you've got here chains, so you don't need to know anything. Like, if I want to, you see, my mic, I'm going to the vocal strip and taking male vocal. Okay, let me show you. Let's remove them. Now you will hear my voice differently. Now let's make a male pop. Hey, hey, hey. Let's do a male live. Okay, you can see it's changing everything. You've got here the compressor, the pro EQ, the expander. Here, this is without the expander, this is with the expander, the Empire. So this Empire, I don't know what it is, but many people talk about it, so I need to see what it is. So this is making my voice very strange, like if I cancel it, my voice coming back to be normal again, and without the extender and the compressor and the Pro EQ. Let's leave the Pro EQ, it sounds good. The compressor, it's too strong for me. Anyway, let's remove them all. And you've got such effects for your guitars, everything you want, mixing, mastering, everything you want. You don't need to know nothing, okay? So one of the downsides here is the drum section, because there are loops here and there are options for you to make drums, but there isn't any drum machine, sort of, I think. Maybe there is, and I don't know, but I didn't found it, because if you are going to the instrument, the main instrument for drums is the Presonus impact. Let's put it here so you can see. So the impact is a sort of drum machine. You've got it many loops. Let's see. Of course, you can drum yourself and make a beat and loops and everything, but I like the old simple drum machine that you can. There is here loops here of famous drummers and things like that. But anyway, this is endless loops. Let's see the urban joints. Okay, as I told you before, there are many features and sounds here. And it's going to be fun ride. And for only $15 a month. So for me, it's a big like. It's very affordable and very professional system. And you've got here preset. Decent sounds. I don't know even what it was, but decent sounds, decent everything, okay, so Ah, okay. Now I understand. Gorgeous piano is my is the SK concert grand of Kauai. At the end we are going back to our favorite instrument. So this was my review. Of course you can fix your vocals and so many features here. So it's worth a while. You can buy a course, even though at the subscriptions you have many courses about how doing things the professional way, but there are courses at Udemy for working with Studio One pretty thorough, even mixing and mastering and everything. So I think it's worth it. So if you like this content, please subscribe and hit the like button so you will go over things like this. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye-bye.